Hey guys, welcome to Math Class with Ms. Brown. Before we get started with today's lesson, make sure you guys subscribe to this channel for more fun math videos. And make sure you guys like this video and share it with your family and friends. Now let's get started with today's lesson. So in today's class, you guys are going to learn how to multiply using the Lattice method, right? So you have your criteria for success in front of you. And it says you have to create a box. Then you have to write the first factor at the top of the box, write the second factor at the side of the box, divide the box into sections, place a diagonal line inside of each box, multiply each digit at the top with each digit at the side. Then you have to add up all the numbers diagonally. I know that's a lot of steps, but I'm going to show you guys exactly what I'm talking about. Let's jump right into the lesson. So we have 52 times 3, right? So this is our first equation. Our CFS at the top says to create a box. I already drew a box on the board. And then it says write the first factor at the top of the box. So our first factor is 52. I'm going to write 52 on top of the box, but I'm going to make sure I keep a space in between those two digits. Then it says write the second factor at the side of the box. So the second factor is just a one digit, which is 3. You just write it on the side. Then it says divide the box into sections. In order to do this, you have to make sure that you draw that line going down vertically between both of those digits at the top. And then you don't need to draw a line going horizontally because we only have a one digit number on the side. Then it says place a diagonal line inside of each box. So I'm going to take it from one point at the top all the way down to the bottom. There we go. And then I'm going to do another diagonal line just like that. All right, there we go. And then it says we have to multiply each digit at the top with each digit at the side. So I'm going to start with the 5, and I'm going to take that 5 and multiply it by the 3 on the other side. So we have 5 times 3, right? So I'm going to write the equation. So 5 times 3. And what is 5 times 3? 5 times 3 is 15. So 15 is a two-digit number, and as you can see in this box right here, you have two different sections. So I'm going to put the 1 there and the 5 there, okay? Each of those boxes always have two sections. So we have to make sure we fill those with the two digits, all right? So now we have 2 times 3. So I'm going to go ahead and do 2 times the 3, right? So let's go ahead and write our equation. We have 2 times 3. So 2 times 3 is 6. But look, 6 is a one-digit number. But remember, we needed two digits. So we have 6. We're just going to add a 0 in front of that because we need two digits in order to fill those two sections up. Okay, so whenever you have a single-digit number, always add the 0 in front of it. So now we are going to just add our numbers diagonally. So here, right, we got 3 sections going diagonally, as you guys can see. So 6 is, that's the only number there. So 6 plus nothing is 6. The 0 plus the 5 is 5, and the 1 plus nothing is 1. So now, our digits, let me rewrite that again. Let me make that look like a 1 because it's kind of slanted. So there we go. Perfect. So now we have 156, so our final answer is 156, and that's it. That's it. What do you guys think? Is it a go? Is it a no? All right, we're going to try another one. So here we have a two-digit by a two-digit. The first equation, we had a two-digit by a one-digit. So this one is going to be probably a little bit more complicated, but let's just take a look. So we have our first factor, 63. We added the 63 at the top of the box, like the CFS says. And then the second factor, which is 24, put it at the side. Always make sure you leave space in between both of your digits, okay? And that's because when we divide the box into sections, we have to make sure there's space in the middle to allow that line to go down just like that. And now on this side, we have two digits. We're going to put that line down the middle as well, right? So now we're going to make sure that we take each of those sections. Let me fix this line. Yeah, let me just fix those because those are, yeah, much better, okay? So you guys have to make sure that your lines are straight. They don't have to be perfect, but you know, you just want to make sure your work is organized, right? So, all right, cool. So now we are going to, oh, let me fix that. Sorry, guys. There we go. Yes, better. All right, so now we are going to take each of those four sections and put our diagonal line. There we go. And when you make your diagonal line in each of those sections, we're going to bring this one through all the way down. Make sure you extend the line out of the box. That's because when we get our final answers, we have to put them in between those lines. You guys will see, just in case you forgot. All right, so we are going to multiply each digit at the top with each digit at the side, right? So our first digit at the top is the 6. So I'm going to take that 6 and I'm going to multiply it by the 2, and then I'm also going to multiply it by the 4, right? So now let's write our equation. So we have 6 times 2, right? And 6 times 2 is 12. 12 is a 2-digit number, so I'm going to fill those in just like that. Then 6 times 4, 6 times 4, 6 times 4 is 24. And that is also a 2-digit number, so I'm going to go right ahead and put that at the bottom right there, right? So now we are done with the 6. We are done. We multiplied the 6 by the 2, and we multiplied it by the 4. So now we are going to do the 3. So we have 3 times 2 and 3 times 4. So first we have 3 times 2, right? And 3 times 2 is 6. Now remember, 6 is a 1-digit number, and we have to make it a 2-digit number, so we're just going to add the 0 in front of it, and there we go, just like that. And then we have 3 times 4, 3 times 4, and 3 times 4 is 12, and that is a 2-digit number. We're going to put that right in that last section. So now we are done. We multiplied the 3 with the 2 and the 3 with the 4, so now we're going to add our numbers diagonally. Right, so we have 2 plus nothing, which is 2. Now this section here diagonally, we had the 6, the 1, and the 4. So 6 plus 4 is 10, plus the 1 is 11. So that's a 2-digit number. I'm going to put the 1 down here and carry the other one over in the next section. So we have a 2, a 2, a 1, and a 0. So 2 plus 2 is 4, plus the 1, which is 5. There we go. And then 1 plus nothing, which is 1. So our final digits are 1512, 1512. 12. That is our final answer. What do you guys think now? Is it getting better for you? All right, let's try one on your own. So here's what I want you guys to do. Pause this video, get your paper and pencil, and try this problem on your own. I know this is a 3-digit by a 2-digit, and it's going to be a little bit more challenging, but just give it a try. And when you're done, we're going to come back together and go over it. Okay, you guys should be done. All right, so we have our box, and then we're going to take our first digit, and it's 245. That's a 3-digit number, so just make sure you keep space in between each of the digits. And then we're going to take that second factor, and we have 32. There we go. And now we are going to divide the box into sections, and we are going to create our lines, but make sure the lines are in the middle between two of the digits, so between a 2 and a 4. That's the middle. Between the 4 and the 5, that's the middle. And then on the side between the 3 and the 2, that's the middle. We're going to bring that line over. And now we are going to just draw our diagonal lines inside of each box. So let's do it just like that. Just make sure you guys are trying to be as straight as possible, okay? Just like that. That's kind of crooked. Got to go back and fix that. Let's do this one here. There we go. There we go. Oh my God. Those are crooked. Let's erase it. Let's do that one again. No, let's try it. Oh, let's just fix this one first. And this goes to show, guys, even though I'm a teacher, sometimes I mess up too and I have to start all over. Right? Just take your time and we'll get it. Okay? So, all right, I think this is good. All right, so we're going to do the 2. We're going to do the 2 first. That's the first digit. And then we are going to multiply it by the other side, which is the 3, right? So we have 2 times 3, and we're going to write our equation. Well, no, let's not write the equation. 2 times 3 is 6. We know that. We're going to write the 6 in the first box. Always remember, if it's a 1-digit, just add the 0 before it, just like that. So now 2 times 2. What is 2 times 2? 4. Yep. Add the 0 first and then put the 4. There we go. So we're done with the 2. So now we're going to go ahead to the 4. So 4 times 3, which is 12. 12 is a 2-digit number. So there we go. Just add the 12. And then 4 times 2, which is 8, which is a 1-digit. Add the 0 before it. Just like that. We are done with the, There we go. Let's fix that. We are done with the 4. So now let's go to the 5. 5 times 3 is 15. There you go. And then 5 times 2 is 10. There you go. So we multiply the 5 by each digit on the side. And let's just cross those out too because we don't need them. We don't want to get confused. So now let's just add diagonally. 0 plus nothing is 0. Now that side, right, we have that section. We have 5 and 1 and 8. 8 plus 5 is 13 plus 1 is 14. We put the 4 down. We carry the 1 over. And we have the 4, 2, and 1 and 1. 4 plus 2 is 6 plus the 2, which is 8. And then that section, 6 plus 1, which is 7. So we have a 7842, right? So 7,840. And that is our final answer. I hope you guys really enjoyed this strategy. You guys did amazing. And if you didn't, that's okay. I just wanted to show you guys this strategy just so you can have another way on how to multiply. Okay, that's the end of today's lesson. You guys did amazing. Remember, it's going to take more practice. But before you go, make sure you subscribe to this channel, like this video, and share this video with your classmates and your family and friends if they need help in math. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at Ms. Brown_the_math_teacher and on TikTok at Ms. Brown the math teacher. I'll see you guys in the next class. Bye.